Well, welcome now, Thursday, the 16th of April. I never thought we'd still be hanging out in the bunker and broadcasting on Facebook at this date, but it's an exciting day to be doing this. My name's Nick Thompson. Happy to be here on National Public Radio Music Day. Sometimes I feel like in my life, every day is Public Radio Music Day, but this is a national celebration of music that you get only on public radio, the programming that is often locally focused and oriented around music that matters to you and our geographic footprint here at WEMU and 89.1. Nick Thompson again, that's my name, and I host a program on Sunday mornings, and we hear music that's driven locally and cruising worldwide and throughout the country every Sunday morning at 10 a.m. Today's special because it's National Public Radio Music Day. We're going to be doing three of these little mini episodes on Facebook and featuring sort of different aspects of WEMU's music programming. And the theme that holds them all together, besides the overarching theme of public media, Public Radio Music Day, is that all of this music makes you feel good. I really have been trying to do that from the bunker while we self-isolate and are separated from each other, play uplifting music that'll help you get through it. So that's going to be true of all three of the selections and artists and albums that we sample today. And so I really wanted to go with stuff that's kind of like core in the vein of WEMU and that you dig on. And the first piece we're going to listen to, and I'm going to get it up here because we don't have a ton of time for these. Do you know this one? This is Taj Mahal. Got a bird, what a whistle. Baby got a bird, honey got a bird, we'll sing. I can't help but smile, and I have a very soft spot in my heart for Taj Mahal. I just love the man. So this is 1968 and his album, The Natural Blues. Oh, man. Oh, man. I'll put up this is the way the CD looks these days. The original album artwork was a little bit different. It was an illustration. I'll get that up for you to take a look at. This is a great record from him from 1968. I think what I like about this album is it's pretty representative of his sort of eclectic approach to the music. And you've got some sort of hardcore core blues on this album. You've got some R&B. There's some Memphis horn lines in it, or at least that sound in the album. He's got great musicians alongside of him. And I love the cover here, the reinterpretation and rearrangement of a traditional piece, and that's Carina, Carina. I love mama, my heart looks so. One of the things I love about this album is the band that he has along with him. And this is largely the band he was working with at the time. And you got some surprise guests on the album as well, and they make a big difference, especially on the tune that we're going to hear more of here in a moment. But Taj is working on the steel guitar. He plays harmonica. There he is. You've got Jesse Ed Davis, Jesse Edwin Davis. He is a Native American musician he's played with. Eric Clapton, he played with George Harrison, and he played with Taj Mahal. He's a guitarist. He does some writing with Taj, some of the arranging as well. He plays piano. He's really an exceptional musician, and we don't hear enough about Jesse Davis, so it's nice to talk about him a little bit today. You got Gary Gilmore, the bassist on the album, and Chuck Blackwell on drums. Al Cooper shows up as well on piano. That's right, the accidental organist from Dylan's Like a Rolling Stone, who stumbled into that one. Oh, lucky. Better be lucky than good if you're Al Cooper, but he's something else. He plays piano on this album in a few spots, and in fact, that's where we're going to go next as we kind of get through the last little bit of Carina here. Carina, oh Carina. When I say that's where we're going to go next, it's to the song that I really wanted to play for you and feature for you today as we enjoy Taj Mahal. And that's She Caught the Cadian and Left Me a Mule to Ride. It's a great opening. She Caught the Cadian. This is the one that we're going to hear the most of today as we enjoy Taj Mahal. telling you. He plays harmonica. In fact, the harmonica sound he uses to, not necessarily on this song, but to give you kind of a Memphis horn sound in a few spots on this album. This is a great one, isn't it? This is a Yank Rochelle piece that Taj has reauthored some of the lyrics on, rearranged. And love listening to him sing. You know, Taj Mahal, he's closing in on 80 years of age. And I think about 20 years ago, he moved to Hawaii. He is nobody's fool. He's been living out there playing a ukulele and living in Hawaii. That's a good idea. That's where I should be. We've had snow this week. He's laughing all the way to the pineapple tree. I love my baby. She's so fine. I wish she'd come to see me sometime. If she don't believe I love her, look what a hole I'm in. If she don't believe I'm singing, look what a shape I'm in. Love Taj's harmonica on this track. So, by the way, this is 1968. WEMU celebrating 55 years in 2020. That means we got underway in 1965. And I'll tell you, we've been playing Taj Mahal for almost the entirety of that history. He is, we got core records at WEMU where all the go-to records are. And there's a whole wall of blues. There's a lot of Taj Mahal on that wall. There should be. I'm going to let him play you out. Stick around. We're going to do this twice more today. We got Eddie Harris and Dick Siegel later. Nick Thompson from The Bunker on Facebook with WEMU and 89.1. I'm glad you're here. Happy Public Radio Music Day. My baby called the Katie, left me a mule to ride. The train pulled out and I swung on behind.